Hello, here is the next SolidSteel parametric for Autodesk Inventor video, today on the subject of welded assemblies. Let's start directly. We're going to create an end plate using the tool of the same name. To do this, simply select a profile and then the face to which you want to join. We choose a standard end plate. Get the preview and can confirm right away. As we can see here in the structure tree, SolidSteel has now created a new welded assembly, containing the beam and the end plate. In other words, all the components that are welded together. Of course, this also works with more complex connections, as we will see here. Again, this profile is connected to this face. Also using the standard plate, but this time we're going to choose the double end plate option. Okay, we can execute that again. Now the software creates the appropriate welded assemblies again. Here we see the welded assembly with the horizontal beam and an end plate, and here we see a second welded assembly with the counterpart of the end plate welded to the column. Of course, SolidSteel Parametric can not only create new welded assemblies, but also extend existing ones. For example, we now place ribs here in the column, this profile, aligned with this edge, and the offset is adjusted so that everything is flush at the top, and confirm. And down here we quickly add more ribs. Same principle, first select the profile, then an edge to align, set the offset and confirm. I forgot to select the single rib option at the bottom. This of course means that the bolts on the double end plate are no longer accessible. This shouldn't happen in practice, but it's not a problem here, as we're only dealing with software functions for welded assemblies and, as we can see, the welded assembly with the column has now been automatically extended to include the ribs. The whole thing works across all functions. Let's now, for example, connect the bracing here at this point. We do this using the gusset tool by selecting the faces that we want to connect, and then confirm. Here is the finished gusset plate, which is now part of the welded assembly with the column. This means that all the parts that are to be welded together are automatically combined into welded assemblies. On the one hand, this is very clear when designing, but it is also extremely useful for subsequent processes such as bills of materials where the welded assemblies are also listed individually. Of course, if there are reasons not to create welded assemblies automatically, you can disable this feature in the preferences. Well, now we have seen that components that are usually welded are automatically sorted into welded assemblies. However, there are also situations where SolidSteel Parametric does not do this, and we will now take a look at this. Now we want to weld a support here, for example for a crane runway. To do this, we first create a beam, rotate it to the correct orientation, move it down so that we have more room at the top, and confirm. Okay, now the beam is just there for the moment. We will cut it with a face cut by selecting the face and then the beam. Looks better now, but in the real world it would just fall down unless the beam is welded to the column. Therefore, assigning it to the welded assembly would be logical, and this is possible with the weldment feature of SolidSteel. This allows us to extend a welded assembly by first selecting the correct welded assembly and then adding the relevant component. Confirm and our new support is also part of the correct welded assembly, and we achieve a clean structure of our design. Okay, so much for welded assemblies. Of course, you can also remove them or create them manually. The best way to find out for yourself is to download and test the express version of SolidSteel Parametric. It costs you nothing and you can try all the features for as long as you like. By the way, subscribing to our channel and liking this video won't cost you anything either, but we'd love it if you did. Goodbye and see you next time.